I were to compare today with when we first came to Rochester in 1969, I would say that the main issues in 69 were housing, segregated schools, poor schools, and income inequality. Unfortunately, those things still exist in Rochester to a great degree.
So Rochester today has schools in the city of Rochester that are vast majority students of color, especially African American and Latino, Hispanic, and especially students, many of them low income. And that's a pattern that we really see across the country.
At the Urban League, at our national level, each year we publish a book called The State of Black America. And what we do is we look at disparities as it relates to education, disparities as it relates to income, as it relates to wealth, as it relates to access to health. And in all those areas, disparities still remain. We know that when you look at the number of African-American males that are graduating high school and going on to college, that's a population that's dwindling. Here with our after-school academy, we work with the guidance counselors and we work with the advisors in the schools to identify young folks who may be on the border and really struggling to do the right thing so that we can provide those resources they need so that they can be successful. One of the programs that we put on is called Project Ready. Project Ready is a program that provides tremendous educational opportunities for African American males. So it prepares them for college, it provides the mentoring to prepare those young folks so that they can compete, number one, in high school, and number two, that they can go on to college and also compete in college.
I would probably still be in a different grade. I would probably still be facing the problems that I have at home. I wouldn't have the same encouragement, the same perseverance, determination. So I would have a totally different life if I hadn't come to this program. Before this program, I think a challenge that I faced was my focus in school, and I believe the Urban League changed that because they have let me know that they're here for me no matter what happens. So that makes me feel as though I can come to them for anything.
No matter what kind of circumstances a student may live in, they have to find a way to be the kind of change they want to make in their own lives and in the community. It is sometimes very difficult. They don't always have the resources that they think their neighbors have, or they may not have the kinds of freedom that some students have, or they don't have cars. There are just lots of things, but they shouldn't concentrate on what they don't have. As a student, you need to figure out, what is it I do have? What are the opportunities I have? Who are the people I can go to help share with me how I can maximize my strengths and how I can get rid of my weaknesses? Because it is taking charge of your own life that is very, very important.